get their work done, people in your organization collaborate with others both inside and outside your organization. This means that the content no longer stays behind a firewall. It can roam everywhere across devices, apps, and services. And when it roams, you want it to do so in a secure, protected way that meets your organization's business and compliance policies. Sensitivity labels from Microsoft Purview let you classify and protect your organization's data, making sure that user productivity and their ability to collaborate isn't hindered. In this video, I will show you how to create and apply sensitivity labels on emails and watermark documents. So let's begin. So first, we just have to go to Microsoft Purview, and then on Purview, we go to Information Protection. And then on Information Protection, we go to Labels to create a label, and then we go Create a Label. So for the purpose of this demo, I pre-created a label for you because it usually takes 24 to 48 hours for the label to be created and applied. So in this scenario, I created a label called cat label test. You can see the name here, display name, description for users, cat label watermark and label test, description for admins, and label colors if you want to classify it by colors. And then once you're happy, you just go next. And then scope. In this scenario, I'm just gonna just check items and include meetings. Group sites, uncheck. And then I want to apply content marking, meaning I want to mark emails with headers and then documents with headers and basically watermark text. So just go next. And then content marking settings. So we're going to add a watermark. You can customize the text. So in this demo, the text name would be cat project, font size is 80. You can edit the color. I'm just gonna put red here. And then text layout, diagonal. And for watermark, this text will appear as watermark only on labeled documents. It won't be applied to any email messages. So save. And then for headers, we can customize that too. And for this one, it says this text will appear as a header on labeled email messages and documents. So you'll see this on your email messages and then the documents that you want to label. So header text would be the same, cat project, font size would be 20. You can edit it if you want to, same as colors, same as alignment. So when you're happy, press save. This scenario, I'm not going to add a footer. Just press next because I don't want to auto label. I'm just going to leave these settings blank and then press next. And then review your label settings. And once you're happy, press finish or save a label. So in this scenario, the name of my label is cat label test. Display name would be cat label test. And description would be this one. And the scope would be I can apply it on files or documents, on emails, and then meetings that I create. Content marking, the watermarks text would be cat project. And I believe you'll see it diagonally. And the text size would be 80. And then the color is red. And also for headers, it would be centered, the text size would be 20, and then the color is red. So mind you, for the watermark, you're only going to see it on the document, but not on the email. But for headers, you're going to see it on your email and then your document. So once you're happy, just go save label. And then that's done. So it says label updated here because I pre-created this label. But in your scenario, if this is a brand new label, it will say label created. So done. So we're done with the first step. First step is to create the label. Second step is to apply that label. So let's go to label policies. And then to publish the label or apply the label, just look for that label. And then it says edit policy here. And then choose the sensitivity labels to publish. So in this scenario, the label that we created is cat label test. So this is good. And then just go next. And then I want everyone, every user and groups in my tenancy to be able to apply this. Next. And then I'm just going to leave the policy settings blank for now. Let's go next. And then basically it will ask you settings for each of these. We just go next. And then name your policy and enter a brief description. So I named it. Let's go next. And then review. And then submit. So policy is updated. Now we're going to do testing. So I tested the email header. So what I did was I used my tenancy sandbox and then sent it to my personal Gmail. And as you can see, this is my email message. And then I applied the label on that particular email. As you can remember, the email is centered. The text name is cat project. And then the size is 20. And then the text is red. So as you can see, it's all applied here. So email is working. So now we're going to check the how to apply labels on the document. So I opened a little cat document here, and then we'll check, or I'll demo how to apply the label on your documents. So in this scenario, I open up Word, and I'll search for the sensitivity label icon here on your top ribbon. Just go drop down menu, and then the sensitivity label that we created is here. So I'm just going to check that. And then boom, the label is applied. So as you can see, there's a header. The header, as you can remember, it's centered, font size 20, and then text is red. And then text color is red. And then the text is cat project. And then also the watermark is text watermark is cat project, as you can see here. Font size is 80. Text color is red, and then it's applied diagonally. So applying the sensitivity label in the documents worked. So to recap, in this video, you learned how to create and apply sensitivity labels on emails and watermark documents. With sensitivity labels, you can apply you can identify the sensitivity of data across your organization, and the label can enforce protection settings that are appropriate for the sensitivity of that particular data. Again, if you like this video, this is Ed from Regroove. Give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Bye.